Shalom, shalom, shalom. First and foremost, I would like to give all praises to the Most High Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Mordechai Kodash. I'd like to send my double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, GMS, for having taught me this truth, which is the 100% truth. Peace and salutations to the hopeful elect spread around the four corners of the earth, laboring in the vine in these last days, and on to those who are sincerely seeking the truth. Shalom. This is going to be a brief lesson. I just have the Spirit strong on me, which I'm really grateful to the Most High Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. You know, I just wanted to share a little testimony of, you know, what's been going on with me, you know. So here in Italy, you know, in the plantation where I work, you know, where I slave out, you know, just I've been catching hell lately, you know. Ever since I tried, you know, teaching a few people about the truth, you know. So due to this, I started catching different hells, you know. I started looking at me in a different way, even to the extent of this thing getting to my boss and stuff like that, you know. So, you know, I started getting maltreated, you know. So, you know, and it's really bad and ugly when you have to wake up in the morning and go work in a place where, you know, you're not happy. You know, the people that are there, you know, they don't make things easy for you, you know. I don't really care about someone talking to me or not talking to me, you know. It's all about, you know, cooperation, you know, at work, you know, so the time flies, you know. So, but when everyone is against you, you know, time doesn't really fly. So I've been catching, just to shorten the story, I've been catching all different kind of L's, you know, at work, even to the point of, you know, almost getting really physical, you know. So that's with my boss, actually, you know. So anyway, to cut the whole story short, you know, I've been praying to the Most High Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. You know, this thing has been really been bothering me because, you know, I want to start looking for another job, you know. And I'm a little bit worried, you know, because now, you know, we easily can get these jobs, you know, here in Italy, you know. There are not very that much jobs, you know, job opportunities where I actually live, the region where I'm living now. And, you know, and due to this Crown Royal shit, you know, they'll be telling people to go get the vaccine, you know. So, and I don't want to participate in all this because I already had my plans, you know. Once they just make it, you know, like obligatory where I work, then man is quitting, you know. Man, I have different other plans, you know, just ready. So whenever they make it obligatory, I'm just quitting and that's it. So before then, I don't want to stress myself going elsewhere to look for other jobs and stuff like that, you know. So I've been praying actually to the Most High Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, to help me out in this situation, you know. I've really been praying, you know, and this thing has really, like, you know, been disturbing me to the extent of me not being able to know, to make my teachings and stuff like that, you know. So I just decided to fast over it, you know, fast and, you know, and pray. And all, you know, a situation just, you know, happened at work, you know, and, you know, all hell kind of broke loose, you know. The Most I kept the kind of spirit in me, you know. I almost went physical, you know, and all this thing happened. And I'm not saying we should do this, you know. I almost went physical, but, you know, the spirit was on me to do so. But I didn't go physical, you know. So, you know, it was surprising because I was actually in fasting, you know. And, you know, I was just trying to, like, keep the reverence, you know, praying in my spirit, praying in my heart, you know. You know, you work with these different Edomites and different kind of people, you know, with different spirits and demons, you know. So they, when they see that you have that light, you know, I'm saying this because, you know, I know many brothers are also going through this kind of situation, you know. But you just have to put your whole trust in the Most High Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. So, you know, things got really hot that, you know, we now needed, like, I was sent home anyway. I was sent home, you know. I came back home, you know, and I was just giving all praises to the Most High Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, knowing that He's going to make a way. He's going to make a way. He's going to make a way, you know. Putting my whole trust in the Most High Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Then, you know, we had the general boss came over, you know. So he was included also in this situation. And he got the chance to listen to every one of us, you know. And my prayer was actually the most I should confound these people. You know, anyone who's planning, you know, to lie on me and, you know, do stuff that are wrong to me, you know, the most I should confound them. Man, to my greatest surprise, man, that was exactly what the most I did, you know. And these people actually looked stupid, you know. They looked stupid, even the guy who's actually a direct boss, you know. So it looked stupid, you know. And at the end of the day, you know, we came up with a conclusion that we should just, you know, squash the whole beef and everything, you know. So we all shook hands and, you know, everything came back to normal. And, you know, I'm really, really happy, not because of the job or anything, because, you know, to hell with all this job and whatever, man. Man is just praying that, you know, the most I help Hashem, how shy should hasten the time and we should get out of here, man. I'm tired catching hell, having needing to wake up early in the morning and, you know, go slave out for my slave masters, you know. So, you know, it's just, you know, it's surprising because, you know, the prayers I've been praying, the most I how about Shemi, how shy should confound these people, you know, everything just, you know, was just plain in my eyes. And man, it's a big testimony for me. I don't know if anyone can feel what I'm feeling now, you know, probably not, but this is a huge testimony for me. And, you know, I'm grateful to the Most High Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Ruka Kodash. And, you know, this leads me to this book of Matthew chapter 7, which says, "Ask and it shall be given you, seek and you shall find, knock and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be opened." Okay? So, exactly, this scripture is actually true. You know, as long as you're doing the right things you have to do in this truth, which is studying your scriptures, you know, learning more, praying constantly, fasting frequently, you know, trying your best to put into practice all this commandments that's been given by the Most High, which these commandments are not heavy, you know. Become a style, a lifestyle, you know. And once you get into it, once you've been baptized by the word, you know, a change comes into your life, you know. All these things becomes very easy, you know. It becomes like a lifestyle. So you see, the Most High never leaves his people. He never leaves his people behind. I've done different videos, you know, regarding, I don't know now if I did them in Italian, probably did some in Italian and some in English, you know. The Most High has never left his people behind, you know. Whenever, if you read from the book of Chronicles, from the book of Kings, you know, tells you a different story when the Israelites are going to find themselves, you know, in serious conditions, you know, in which they're surrounded by their enemies and, you know, and the Most High is always going to make a miracle, get them out. You know, so this is what it is, man. Brothers, Akiams and a few Akwats, you know, in the truth, just step up your game, man. Step up your game because, you know, things are really getting serious and we don't know. This might be the year, you know. This might be the year, as the apostles are saying it, you know. This is the time we need to pray and do our best to hasten this work to come to pass, you know. Man, we should get out of this kingdom and, you know, the next kingdom is what we're expecting, you know. So I just wanted to share this quick testimony and I hope, you know, it edifies someone today. Hopefully I'll go deeper into some other lessons, you know, with more scriptures. And having said this, I'd like to give all praises to the Most High Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Ruka Kodash, Barakata Yahweh Shai. And I would like to give my double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone GMS for having taught me this truth, which is the 100% truth, and also for ruling well. And, you know, peace and salutations to the hopeful elect spread around the four corners of the earth. Shalom unto the next one.